So the game I have decided to call Poop Scoops. And this game is, I'm going to give you two headlines and you have to tell me which one is real.
Okay.
And they are all poop themed.
Okay, love it.
So we're gonna hit these headlines.
Very on trend nowadays.
Very on trend. Very I've heard. Yeah. I've heard.
911.
All of our students, they're all pooping.
Who could have had a motive and who could be a suspect?
What if the motive is just poop is funny?
Poop is funny.
Why do you think American Vandal has been so popular and gone so viral since season one?
I think because the crime is so stupid, but we take it so seriously that it's just, and all the fans of true crime are obsessed, they're very much obsessive with that kind of stuff. So I think, I think that those are kind of the reasons why. And we have a great cast and our creators are freaking brilliant and our writers and everybody. It's such a fun project to be a part of, and it's definitely my favorite thing I've ever done.
Here's your first two. Okay. Which one is real and which one is fake? Owner charged with crime after horse defecates on child at parade.
Okay.
It's gonna be really hard for me not to laugh, because poop is funny, as you guys say.
Poop is funny.
And also your second headline, man charged with crime after he diarrheaed so hard the ricocheting poop hit a child.
Okay, I'm gonna say that one is false and the first one is true.
Oh, you're wrong.
I'm wrong?
In the first
one. No.
Somebody actually pooped so hard that it hit a baby in a stroller.
Wait, what?
It's terrible news.
And he got in trouble?
He was charged with a crime. He was charged
for ricocheting poop?
Yep.
He couldn't hold it,
went on a crosswalk, hit a baby, it was a whole thing. We're gonna have links, by the way, we're gonna have links to these in the description. So if you wanna check out these stories, you can feel free to read all about them. The true stories anyway, I can't give you links to the made up ones.
Ricochet.
Although, poop. I mean, the idea of a horse pooping on a kid at a parade is...
That sounded more...
Pretty terrible.
Oh my God, ricocheting poop? What, was he having uncontrollable diarrhea?
He clearly was poisoned.
He's got
the
some
lemonade
serious,
was tainted.
Yeah, but he's got some serious talent. I mean, that come is, on.
I buy it. I agree. Okay, so how has your character Peter changed from season one?
Well, Peter, it's different because, Peter's now a successful documentarian. Netflix bought his documentary, so he knows about all that.
Oh, we're getting meta.
Yeah, we're getting very meta here. Okay. So Netflix reaches out to him. They tell him that they love his video and his documentary series on Vimeo, and then they re-edit it and send it out. So Peter's like grown up a bit, and he has a little bit more confidence, and he's solving a new crime with his best buddy.
I would imagine there's a little bit more pressure on him.
There's a lot more pressure on Peter, definitely, because, he made an amazing documentary, and now it's time to solve a new crime. And
gotta
can
prove
he
you're
solve
not a one-hit wonder.
Exactly, and can he solve it? I'm not a one-trick pony, is that the...
Yeah, one-trick pony, that's it.
Okay.
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, we move from dicks to upgrade.
Okay, so second pair. Mm-hmm. Drug charges dropped after suspect refuses to poop for 47 days.
Okay, that seems plausible.
Cat burglar confesses to jewelry theft after pooping out stolen rings. I appreciate that you're taking this very seriously.
Oh, no, I'm getting my Peter glasses on. Oh, gosh. Okay. I'm going to say that one is true because I don't think anybody could go for 46 days without pooping.
You know what? You're wrong again.
Are you kidding me?
I can't.
Okay. Peter's not in the building today.
So the story with this guy is, in brief, they think he swallowed drugs. He was in custody, didn't poop for 47 days.
47 days?
And they had to release him for insufficient evidence.
Smart guy.
Because it wasn't out.
But 47 days?
I mean, I guess you just avoid fiber, right? Yeah, that's holding it. I don't know. And then he went outside and pooped on that kid. That must have been the next thing he did. Okay. What is your favorite true life crime or true crime TV show or real life story?
Okay. Wild, Wild Country. Is that the name?
Werewolf I haven't seen
West
that.
Or Wild Wild Country. It's on Netflix. I just binged it. It is my favorite. That and Making a Murder and The Jinx.
Okay.
But Wild Wild
Which
Country.
Obviously American Vandal very heavily influenced.
Right, right. But Wild Wild Country is insane.
Next pair. Okay. All right.
Come on.
Come on. You got to get one.
Come on, Peter.
Right. Soccer team expelled from youth league after covering coach in poop. Chicago woman attacked with sock full of poop.
Oh, gosh.
I feel vindicated that I'm a good headline writer for having fooled you. So I appreciate that.
Okay. So soccer team. throws poop on a coach. Mm-hmm. Okay, and the other one is hitting poop with people on
in a sock. Mm-hmm.
Oh Lord, I better get this right.
Come on, your cred, your poop cred's on the line.
My poop cred is so on the line here. Oh God, the high school.
The soccer team?
Soccer team.
You're wrong.
Are you
again.
Kidding me? Okay, you know what? I'm Tyler. Done playing this game.
Tyler.
No.
We have two more questions.
Well, I guess you're a good poop writer.
I feel like maybe I should
we
start a website.
We should have hired you for season two in the
call
writer's
me.
Room.
So fine. Call me. It's fine. If you need some like headlines for like a beautiful montage of newspaper headlines, like for some bit, let me know. Okay. So as Peter, are there any famous real life or fictional detectives that you based your character on? You watch a lot of Matlock?
What is it called? What's her name? Why am I forgetting of this? Serial. I love her. I'm obsessed with her.
Oh, Sarah.
Sarah Koenig. Okay, sorry. I had a brain fart for a second. I'm obsessed with Sarah. Peter is obsessed with Sarah Koenig and everything to do with Sarah Koenig. And she's incredible and she's so smart and just... everything about her. I'm obviously, you can see I'm fanboying, and I hope to one day meet her.
Oh, I'm surprised you haven't met her
yet. No, I have not, and I'm dying to meet
her. That seems like a good birthday gift.
That would be the best 21st.
A cereal-themed birthday would be really fun.
Oh, God.
So, you've had enough. You're like, I've had enough. All right, here we go. These ones are longer headlines.
Okay.
Shoplifter tries to escape by grabbing poop from her pants and smearing it on security guard's face. Man finally caught on security camera after 10 years of sneaking into neighbor's house to poop. Both crazy.
The first one.
The shoplifter?
Shoplifter.
You're right.
Finally!
You did it!
Jesus Christ!
You made it!
Okay, yes. One for Peter.
Okay. You made it. It's one for you. Okay, so what can fans expect from season two? It's dropping today, I believe. Mm-hmm. So what can fans expect if they're, you know, coming from season one or if someone's new to American
Well,
Dental?
It's a true crime satire series. This season, we follow Peter and Sam investigating a new crime in a new school, St. Bernardine Catholic High School. It's a lot darker. The stakes of this crime are a lot higher, a lot higher. And I also, what I loved about this season is the message at the end of it was really empowering, and to be able to deliver and be, you know, be the person who says that message was so gratifying. And I really felt like I was speaking to the world and to the audience and what's going on. I can't reveal what it is.
No.
Yeah. And it's so what happens at St. Bernardine Catholic High School, the turd burglar tainted the lemonade, the cafeteria lemonade,
right,
causing everybody to poop uncontrollably.
It's terrible.
Absolutely terrible.
What a scene.
What a scene.
What a crime scene.
What a crime scene, and what a crime scene to watch and film. But it was so much fun, and yeah, the stakes were really high, and this crime is, you're not going to be able to figure it out, like, as you're watching it. It's, the amount of twists and turns in this season are freaking incredible.
I can't wait to see the subreddit.
Oh my God.
'Cause they get real deep.
Yeah, they do.
They go in.
They go in all the way. They do.
Okay, sometimes your last two.
Okay.
This one might be easier. Superintendent arrested after allegedly pooping on high school track field.
Okay.
Investigation opened after tainted lemonade causes poop debacle at local private high school.
I'm gonna go with the superintendent pooping on. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the superintendent.
You are correct.
Yes.
It's a real
two
story.
For
you
got two.
You got two
for two.
Two for two. We'll just pretend those first three didn't happen. It's
that,
fine. Two for two. Just, you got a two win streak.
All right.
That's
all right.
I'll take it.
I'll take it.
And of course, that last story is the plot of American Vandal season two, which you can catch on Netflix starting today, right now. You can go watch it. And if you want to see more Tyler, you can of course watch the ET Online interview with our beloved Ash Crossan. It'll show up right here where these trees are. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.
Bye.